The problem for environmental chemicals is that many of them have structures that are not commonly seen in nature, so organisms simply have not had a chance to evolve defenses against these compounds. We've made something like 80,000 synthetic industrial compounds in the last century. And that includes everything from plastics to flame retardants to pesticides that are used essentially to deal with many of the problems that you have in modern life. And they're exceedingly complicated. You have a very, very complex experiment in which all of us are the subjects. And many of these compounds are known to have endocrine disrupting activity, which means that they will bind to our hormone receptors and act like hormone mimics. Many types of diseases, these are things like breast cancer and prostate cancer, are caused by misregulation of our hormone systems. The cell is adapted to deal with compounds in the environment. An analogy we use is to say that cells are a little bit like nightclubs. What we mean by that is that a cell really has to decide what gets in and what doesn't. The mechanism for this is by proteins called drug transporters. And in that analogy, you can think of these as being a bit like the bouncers of a cell. They decide who gets in and who doesn't. And their ability to recognize a compound is very important for determining whether a compound is going to accumulate or be eliminated from the body. So in our lab, what we want to do with that big pile of 80,000 compounds is decide which ones are problems and regulate them accordingly, and have rules for designing safer alternatives. Rather than simply banning a compound, we can actually figure out whether a compound can be redesigned or tweaked in a certain way so that it still gives us the beneficial properties that we want without being as persistent. And that's going to change the face of how we do environmental chemistry, the design of compounds that'll be much safer.